Hello everyone and welcome back to the next episode. And in this episode we'll be talking about order blocks. What are basically order blocks? You have been trading into the financial markets, you have been hearing about SMC, smart money concepts, and you are actually hearing about order blocks. See people using them on their charts and they basically say they trade order blocks. What are order blocks? So order blocks are basically, an order block is basically is an accumulation of orders from financial institutions and central banks. Order blocks are actually special supply and demand zones, right, that are formed when there is a block order, right? That is where this where the name order blocks come from, right? It is formed by buying and selling of the banks and institutions. So basically, let's represent the banks and institutions as what, as the composite man. That's basically what we use, we like to call them, the composite people. So the composite people, the, what they basically do is that when they take their orders, because they actually have a lot of money more than us, like their funds and basically all those stuff, you see a strong momentum pushing to the market, very strong momentum pushing to the market, basically letting we the retail traders know that the banks has taken control. Now that has pushed into the market, they left a gap in these areas to be filled, and hence this order block is always represented as what, the bank orders. So basically price always needs to do what, go back into and tap into the zone of this particular area I highlighted, then it will shoot to the upside. So basically when such zones are discovered, right, you see that there will be either one candle or multiple candles around the area, then a very strong impulsive move to the upside. Hence you can highlight one candle at a time, or you can basically take all the candles to basically give you a clear big pure idea. You can find this back in the lower time frames. So basically what are order blocks again in another sense? So you can see other blocks are special kinds of supply and demand zones formed when there are, when there's a block order. So a block order is basically a lot of money has been pushed into the market around this time. So you are basically saying that, oh, when you see that, you say, oh, money was kept here, then you want to tap into that money. So because the banks always has to come back, tap into this money and continue to the upside, hence the reason why they left this. So we have these types of order blocks. So we have another block whereby you see one candle and a very huge momentum, and sometimes you see the banks probably initiating transactions. When there are transactions, see this particular movement price being manipulated in and out of the market. Sometimes you see a little bit of spikes and all those stuff, right, taking people out and in, and then finally see a very huge movement that an order has been initiated. Hence you have to take an opportunity and then you take the trade to the upside. So this is just the basic understanding of order blocks, and I hope you guys understand this. Now let me go and show you examples of order blocks. So now an order block, I'm going to highlight every single part that I know an order block can be found. I'm just going to be highlighting them. No, I'm not going to, you know, show you, I'm not going to give you a valid or invalid order block. So this basically is an order block because it left price very strongly, and we can call this an order block, right? Though it hasn't tapped into something, but at least it has given a reaction of this particular place. We have a lot of order blocks into the markets. We have this as an order block, right? We have order blocks all over the place, and we have this as an order block too as well, and we have this tapping into this, accepting this one. We have a whole lot of order blocks into the markets, right? So this ones, as I mentioned, you can see price, so basically this one price never came back to tap into it, and it has been left empty. But from that, we have a lot of other blocks into the market, right? So you have this one, you have this other blocks. So you see what I'm talking about? We have a whole lot of other blocks. You see all these areas are all other blocks. And we have this particular one that actually hasn't been tapped. We have a whole lot of other blocks over here. So let's just highlight this whole thing as an other block, right? We have a whole lot of other blocks we can count on. There are very, very plenty, and so you can see this particular place is an order block. So this is just basically it, right? So this one hasn't been tapped, but probably in the future it will be tapped in one way or the other. That is how basically it behaves, right? So you can see, let's see where it has tapped or just kept going down and down. Okay, it hasn't, but what we do know is that in the future it mostly gets tapped into. And you can see, if you just follow up and up, you can see a whole lot of order blocks. As I mentioned, order blocks are basically where price has left in a very strong way. So after this video, I'll be showing you guys how to actually identify areas that are basically supposed to be respected, or you should be expecting order blocks to respect, right? So we have a whole lot of areas. This is an order block too, right? And see how it has tapped nicely and continued to the upside. We have a whole bunch of other blocks, right? So you don't it's not all the time that, so this one we can consider this another block, but this place too is another block, but it is a little bit combined, right? So we have a whole lot of places, as I mentioned, guys. So we have all these ones. You can see how it has respected this one here. You can see a lot of other blocks. You can see this one respected. See, all these ones are going to be respected, right? So a whole lot of other blocks. So that's basically how another block is, and that is basically how the banks operate. Just want to make it very simple for you guys to understand. All these are all basically simple other blocks that you can understand. I don't need to complicate it, and we'll be having the next one, which is liquidity. So you understand liquidity, you understand other blocks and basically how it works. The theory behind other blocks are actually also there. So let's see the theory behind other blocks. The theory of other blocks, right? Forex. Okay, Forex trading. All right, theory of other blocks in Forex trading. So order block is actually an accumulation. I want to actually let you guys see. Basically, there's nothing here to explain, so hence, let's just leave it there. But basically, what actually happens in most cases is I was not even using using a different chat. All right, so basically, you know, the hedge funds in other particular areas are the biggest financial traders in the market, and they basically let you get you trapped into a particular area. So let's say you have a moving direction going to the upside, right? You have a breakout structure, you find an order block currency. So order blocks are basically always created, because anytime there is a push to the upside, it means that the market has taken control of the bankers has taken control of the market. Hence, let's wait for the price to probably come back to that particular area again, then we tap and we go again. We come, we tap, we go again. Hence and forth until the price structure is broken, and then we have a different price structure all along. So in this case, you just follow breakout structure that we learned at the back. Then we have order block being here, price taps into and goes a breakout structure here, another block being here, price taps into and go a breakout structure, price taps into something here and go breakout structure, price taps into something here and go. Then it gradually changes its direction, and that is from a demand to a supply level. We talk about that also in the next episode. It taps and go, it goes back, break of structure, taps and go, basically continue just like that, to and fro, right? So that is basically the simple understanding about order blocks. So hope you understand this one, and hence we'll be having a live call tomorrow. That will be same times 8 p.m. and hopefully we don't have any light out on my end. And yeah, so see you guys in the next episode.